Well, hello Internet, and welcome to part 24 of my Android development tutorial. Today I'm going to talk about how to create dialog boxes and how to pass data between different activities. Okay, so basically what we're going to do is this guy right here is known as contactFragment.java. That is the object that we created, or the activity, or whatever you want to call it. Basically what we're going to do here is if the person double clicks down here where the date is, a dialog box is going to open up and we're going to be able to flip through the different dates and enter a birthday. And in this tutorial, like I said before, this part right here is going to be represented by contact fragment, while this part over here is going to be represented by date dialog fragment. And just to wrap your head around what's going on, contact fragment is going to show inside of your little app window. We're going to enter in enter birthday. They're going to click on that. Whenever they do, inside of contact fragment, fragment manager is going to be created, which is going to create a date dialog fragment. They're going to enter their date information. Whenever they exit the dialog, it's going to call up here to contact fragment, and then contact fragment is going to change the birth date for the contact and change the value in the editable text window. And that is what we're going to create in code, and I have a lot to do, so let's get into it. Okay, so here we are inside of Eclipse, and specifically we are in contact.java, and of course, since we're going to be entering in a birth date here, we need to put that inside of our contact, and it's going to store a date, and I'm going to be covering a whole bunch of different ways of looking at dates in this tutorial as well. There's a whole bunch of things, just like always. So I'm going to come in here, and this is very important, date, and we want to import the Java utility date, not the SQL date. Then on top of that, we need to give it a default date. So I'm going to go date of birth, and this is when the contact is created, and I'm just going to say new date, which is going to give whatever the current date for today is. Obviously that wouldn't be the birthday though. Then we have to create getters and setters for this guy. So let's just come in here, right click, and I'm going to go source, and then I'm going to come down here and look for generate getters and setters, and there that is. And then specifically I want to generate the getters and setters for date of birth, not ID number. Come down here, after, I'm going to put it way at the bottom, right after that, leave everything public of course, and then hit OK. And if we scroll way down here, you're going to see get date of birth and set date of birth. Now there's only one problem with this. If we were to just go get date and put it inside of this editable text box, it's going to also print out the time and all kinds of other stuff, which we don't want. All we want is the month, the day, and the year, and that is it. So that means we're going to have to create yet another way of pulling the date out and just present this information. So let's do that. So still inside of contact.java, I'm going to go public, and I'm going to return a string because that's what we put in an editable text box, and I'm going to call this get date string, and it's not going to receive anything because everything it needs is right here. Then we're going to create a calendar, and this is going to provide us with a way to break this date down into month, day, and years. And to do that, we just call calendar and get instance to generate that guy, and then we're going to go calendar, and we're going to set time to the date of birth, which in essence is passing in the date that we're going to be using, date of birth. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to create year is a number format, and to get that I just go calendar, get calendar and year, and then I'm also going to get the number variation for month of course, and here we're just going to change this to month. But there's something weird. If you ask for January, for example, it's going to return 0 in this situation, so we have to add 1 for January, and all the other ones would be messed up as well. So that's all we need to do to fix that. And then of course we have day as well, and this is day of month is how we access that, and all that's perfectly fine. And then we need to return it as a string, which is easy enough. We're just going to go month plus and put our little dash inside of there, and then we're going to say day, and then finally year. And of course you can change this to whatever makes sense to you, because I know there are tons of people all over the world, surprisingly, that watch these videos, and I think very few people put month, day, and year. So either way, that works. And that is all we're going to need to do with contact to get all this to work. And of course, all of this code is in a link in the description. Next up, we're going to have to go in and create dialogDate.xml. And this is going to define exactly what shows up in our dialog box. So if we just go into our graphical layout, And of course, this is over inside of our layouts. That's where all our layouts are going to go to. And all I'm going to do is go into the time date part of this, and I'm going to grab date picker and I'm going to drop it. And there it is. Date picker shows up inside of there. There, if you didn't see it. All right, so now I'm going to jump over into the regular XML code and change a couple things here. Like, for example, the ID, I'm going to make this birthday picker. So birthday picker, and that makes a little bit more sense. I'm going to let these be wrapped content. And the only other thing I'm going to do here is I am going to mark calendar view shown as false. If you do not do that, what it's going to do is it's going to have two different ways to pick dates, and it's going to cause all kinds of confusion. And the one I'm getting rid of is an actual like calendar that you can use to display all this information. If you want to see what it looks like, just don't use false here, and both of them will show up, but it'll cause all kinds of errors, so probably not a good idea to do that. And that's it, because all we're going to be doing basically is displaying a way for them to enter the date, and so that is going to cover it. Now I'm going to go into strings.xml because in my editable text box inside of contact fragment, I'm going to want to put a little message in there. So just paste this inside of there. And inside of this, I'm just going to call this contact birthday. And then I'm going to put enter birthday. And you're going to see here in a second exactly what that's going to look like. And that's it. Strings.xml is done. So now let's go and actually put in the birthday little box inside of fragment contact.xml. And if we look at the graphical layout, you can see enter phone number and there's the checkbox right there. I want to put the birth date in between the two of those things. So I'm going to go inside of text fields inside of this, and specifically I'm going to get this guy down here that looks like a date. I'm going to drag that over and hopefully it'll go in the right place. Let's see. Looks like it did. Now I'm going to jump inside of here to the actual code and see what we got working with here, or what we are working with here. And there we go. I'm going to get rid of request focus, of course, because that's definitely not the focus of what we're doing here. And then I'm going to put in, get rid of this one and capitalize this E, and then I'm going to put in contact birthday. That seems to make a little bit more sense. Wrap content's fine. This is fine. Didn't I put something in here about bottom margin? Yeah, I want to get that. Copy that over there as well. Let's just put it in there. And then I also want to get the actual string here that we have inside of strings.xml and copy that. Jump back over here again. No point in typing it all out, so let's jump back over into graphical layout. This is highlighted, so I'm going to come over here to the actual text area. Click on that, and there it pops up, and contact birthday. And there we go, and enter birthday shows up inside of there. And everything looks okay there for now. So what I'm going to do now is jump into contactfragment.java and start getting the contact fragment to communicate with the dialog fragment. Now, of course, with the contact fragment, which is going to have all the information in regards to our contact on the screen, well, if we're going to be passing information back and forth between the dialog and this contact fragment, what we're going to want to do is provide a way to send that information using a bundle. And anytime we want to do that, that means we're going to have to go through this process of defining the key value of the key value pair. And I'm just going to call it date of birth and give it a default value of date of birth. No big deal. Like I said before, that's the key value for this guy. Then, of course, we're also going to have a new edit text box that's going to have our birth date inside of it. And I'm going to call it contact birthday edit text, just like we did previously here just a couple seconds ago. And then another thing we're going to do, because we're going to be sending requests back and forth between different activities or different fragments, we're going to want to make sure that whenever a request is made, that it is coming from the dialog box. And one way to track that is to create a private static, an int, that is going to, I'm just going to give a value of request date, and that's going to say, hey, you know, we're requesting a date object, and you're going to see here in a minute that how we're going to track that, and so we're going to know, and how we're going to use this little code right here to know that we are receiving a date information or receiving date information from the date dialog box. That means we're also going to have to set up this editable text area here, or editable text box. So we have to figure out exactly where we want to do that. And just scroll down through here. I'm basically just looking for all the other edit text boxes, and I'm going to place it in here somewhere. So I don't want to put it inside of any type of handler. And I'm thinking right about here, right after we are done with our checkbox, would be as good of a place as any. So paste that inside of there. Now we need to initialize this, so edit text, and then I'm going to get that data using the same thing that I use for everything else, so that's going to be the view, blah 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 blah, so I might as well take that there, paste it inside of it, and then for this guy, I'm going to go dot, and then I'm going to be looking for contact birthday edit text, which is right there. Alright, so we got that information. Now that we have access to be able to edit the edit text box, we need to actually get the right information to put inside of there. And of course, that's going to be stored inside of a contact. So we're just going to go contact birthday edit text and set text. And we're going to get it from contact, of course. And I want to get the string representation of it. So get date string, this guy right here. Because remember, I don't want the time and all that other information there. That wouldn't make any sense. And then I need to set up a click listener so that I will know when it has been clicked on so that I'll be able to open up the dialog box. So I'm going to go set on click listener, just like I've done before. And then we're going to go new on, capital O, click listener. Put in our curly brace, put in our semicolon at the end, and we're going to define this inline right here. And of course it's going to say, hey, you need to add some unimplemented methods, and there it is. And the unimplemented method is going to be, okay, what do we do when the edit text box is clicked on? I'm going to be bouncing between the dialog class and back and forth over and over again. Well, like I told you before, first thing we're going to have to do is create a fragment manager, which is going to manage our fragments for us. And I'm just going to call this frag manager like I normally do. And I just have to go get activity, which is this activity. And then I have to call get support fragment manager. And this is just going to return the specific fragment manager that's going to be used to interact with the fragments in our activity. And of course, I don't need that brace there, and I don't need this brace there, just slipped in. But I am going to need it like that. There we go. Now we have to actually create date dialog fragment, and I'm going to call it date dialog. It doesn't exist yet. We're going to create this. So this is going to be a custom class, custom dialog box, and it's going to be called date dialog fragment. I'm going to create it here in a second, and I'm going to go create new instance, and to it I'm going to pass the date of birth, date of birth, and it's going to create everything from that. And then what I need to do is, remember, the dialog box is going to execute, it's going to do all kinds of things, and then it's going to pass information back. Well, to tell it what to pass back or where to pass information back to, you have to go set target fragment and then say contact fragment, which is the class we're working on, this, and then we're going to say request date, and that is going to tell us that we are dealing with changing the dates. Remember, that was from the very beginning. Where are we at? There we go, right there. So this is how we're going to know that we are dealing with each other and dealing specifically with changing dates. And then after all of that is all set up, we can go date, dialog, and call show, and fragment, frag, manager, and date of birth. Well, now that we have that all set up, it's time to jump over into date, dialog, fragment and start creating this guy. Now, we're definitely not done with contact fragment. We'll be coming back to that in a second, but for the most part, got a lot of it done. Okay, so since we're going to be dealing with dialog boxes, we're going to have this extend the dialog fragment, and of course, it's going to want us to import some libraries. There we go. Now, if we jump back over here again to contact fragment, see where it says date of birth? That's being passed inside of here. Well, we're going to have to set that up as well. We're going to go public static final string again, and this is going to be the key for the birthday that's going to be passed between our activities, just like we had before. Contact birthday is what I'm going to call this, and it's going to be equal to, and for this I'm just going to go com new think tank blah 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 census app, just to make sure it's completely new and won't cause any problems. And I'm going to go contact underscore birthday. So there we go, got that key set up. Then I'm also going to be storing a date inside of here, of course. I'm going to call that contact birthday, and once again make sure that you come in here and get Java utility date, don't get Java SQL. Then after I have all that set up, we're going to have to get the method that's going to create our dialog box. So just right click inside of here, go into source, come over here, override implement methods, and look for create dialog box. Where is it? On create dialog, and of course bundle That's how we're going to pass our information back and forth. And I'm going to put it after contact birthday, and I'm going to go OK. And there it is created. I'm going to get rid of this here for now. Okay, so what exactly are we going to have to do once we start setting up our dialog box? Well, we're going to have to get the birth date that was passed to this activity. And how we do that, we're going to go contact birthday, and we're going to cast it to a date. And then to get arguments that are passed, we're just going to go get arguments, and then we're going to say get serializable. And specifically, what we're looking for is contact birthday. And there it is. And of course, fix that again. And there we are. Then, just like we used before to be able to work with our dates, we're going to create another calendar. And we're just going to say exactly like we did before, calendar, get instance. And just like we did before, calendar, set time. And the time is going to be whatever the value of contact birthday is. So that's pretty easy. And this is just going to be the birthday that shows up inside the dialog box for us to change. Then, because we're going to have to pass in year, month, and day, and all those different things separately, what I'm going to do here is create all that again. Actually, let's jump over into contact and just copy that. Scroll way down here. Here, this is exactly what we want. And then jump back over into the date dialog fragment. And in this situation, the only thing we're going to change, we're going to get rid of that plus one. Because remember, that's just for showing inside of the text boxes if this was a string, which they are not. They are integers. And now that we have that set up, we're going to have to inflate our dialog. So we're going to go view, and I'm going to just call this the view, get activity, get our current activity, and then get layout inflator. There's that guy, and there's the bundle. And then just to keep this a little bit neater, well, I'm going to go here and bring in my libraries. View, and then I'm going to go inflate. And what specifically am I going to inflate? Well, I'm going to inflate the layout called dialog date, which is this guy up here, is one of the first things we created. And null, doggone it, if I don't keep making that mistake. There we go, fix that. And actually, we don't need that right there. Okay, now that we have that, we want to access the date picker in dialog date. So that means we're going to have to go date picker, because that's what it's called. And I'm just going to call it date picker. Date picker, just like we do with all the different components we work with. And jump down to the next page, and then I'm going to say the view. Might as well just get this library while we're here. Then I'm going to go the view and find view by ID. And the name of that is r.id. And then it is birthday picker. There it is. Okay, so now we got that initialized and ready to work with. And of course, put that period inside of there. Then, if our birth date changes with the date picker, we want to be prepared to pass that new value. And how we're going to pass it is go year, month, and day. And then we're also going to go new on date changed listener and figure out exactly what we're going to do when this guy's changed. Put semicolon in there. Then we have to import our libraries and then come in here and add our unimplemented methods. And it's going to say, okay, what exactly are we going to do when the date is changed in our date picker? Well, I'm going to say the contact birthday should be equal to, and in this situation, I'm going to have to go new and call the Gregorian calendar, and then year, month, day, and get time. And then, of course, I have to give these the right name, and this would be year in this situation, and month in this situation, and day, wherever day is. Okay, got that all set up. And then we'd have to go into the Gregorian calendar, get this library again, bring it in there. And then we just need to put the new value in the bundle for passing to our other activity, which is going to be contact fragment. To do that, just like we did before, we're going to go get arguments. And in this situation, we're going to be putting in the new date. So we're going to go put serializable. And we need to use our key, contact birthday, and then the value that we're going to be putting inside of it, which is going to be contact birthday. And there we are. Now that we have that all set up, we're going to have to set up the dialog box by setting a custom view to hold all the contents of the dialog box. We're also going to have to set the title, the type of button we're going to use, what to do when it's clicked. And then finally, the ultimate creation command. So let's just do that all at one place. We're just going to go return new alert dialog. And in this situation, you call builder. And I don't have a theme, so I'm just going to go like that. And the context, of course, is going to be get activity, which is what we always use. It's nice when all this stuff just pops up. Then we have to just define everything that we want to define. So we want to set our view. And the view is going to be the current activity. And then if we want to also set our title, well, and this is going to be our string, and contact birthday, just like we set up previously. And if we want to define what our button's going to look like, we're going to go set positive button. This is okay after they change the date. And the one we're going to use here is Android R string. And this is going to be dot. And we can look through here and see all the different options. But okay looks good to me because that makes sense with a dialog box. Then after that, we have to figure out exactly what are we going to do when they click on the okay button. Well, to do that, we go new, dialogue, interface, and then we're going to say on, capital O, click, listener, and define how we're going to handle that situation. Of course, put the semicolon down there. Come in here, get this library. There we go. And then it's going to be nice enough to tell me what methods I need, add on implemented methods, and there it is. What's going to happen when we click on the OK button? Well, all we need to do is send our result. And to get this, we just go activity. Dot result okay, and then actually we don't need this guy here because remember we have to create our dialog box, so we have to go create and then we can put our semicolon there. And we are still not done with date dialog fragment yet because we have to create send result, and we're also going to have to provide a way for them to create a new instance of date dialog fragment. So if we come out of this area here, we're still in date dialog fragment, and we got to create our method for generating a new instance of this fragment. So I'm just going to create it as a static date dialog fragment and call this new instance, and it's going to get passed a date, which I'm just going to give it the name of date. And if you don't know why I'm doing that, this is the reason why. New instance, see? And contact get date of birth, that's the reason why I'm doing this. I'm creating that guy. So of course we're going to have to create our bundle, and I'm going to call this data passed is equal to new bundle because we're passing over that date information. And then in the bundle, put serializable, and just like before, it's going to be contact birthday and put the date inside of there. Then I'm going to need to create the date dialog fragment and attach the birth date to it. So date dialog fragment, I'm just going to call this date fragment new, and there we go. And then I just have to attach our data to this. So date fragment and set arguments, just like before, data passed. So then we have that information attached to that new fragment. And then the whole idea here was to return a date dialog fragment. So of course, I have to return it. And that just leaves us, if we coast up through here and look for our errors with this send result right here. So let's just copy that. Let's create that method down here. We're going to go private. Void isn't going to return anything. Send result, and it is going to be issued a result code. And remember I said we're going to be using this just to make sure that we are communicating date wise and so forth and so on. So what I want to do here first is check that the target fragment was set up inside of contact fragment. How we do that is go get target fragment, and that's this guy over here, bounce back over here, see, set target fragment. Basically I'm just checking to make sure that this was set. And to do that, you just go, is it equal to null? And if it is, well, just leave. And that's what we did. Then what we're going to need to do is if we have the target set up, we are going to have the intention to provide it with our birth date. So we have the intention to give it the birth date. Because remember, we have to go back to contact fragment after we're done with the dialogue. So we have to create an intent since we have an intention to do something. New intent, the intent. And we're going to have to put our extra information inside of this. And that's contact birthday, of course. The only thing we're worrying about in this. And specifically, the value is going to be contact birthday. And then finally, we have to get the target and have it receive the data. So get target fragment. And we know we have it because of this guy up here. And I'm going to put this on the next line just because it's a little easier. Then I'm going to say on activity result. And we have a request code, which is going to be get target request code, and then we have the result code, and in this situation, the intent. And then if we come up through, there's a little error that we have here. Make sure that we import that guy, and all our errors have gone away. So let's jump over into contact fragment, finish everything up. Basically, what we're going to need to do inside of here is figure out what we specifically are going to do whenever the OK button is clicked inside the dialog box. And to do that, we need to go source, come down here, override implement methods, and we're going to get on activity result. So, fragment on activity result. This guy right here. Put it dead last. And there it is. And get rid of this. Now, the first thing we want to do is we want to check that the result code that was passed is not equal to activity result OK, which is, you know, what we're expecting. And if we get something that we don't expect, we're just going to cancel out of this altogether. If, however, we did receive this from our date dialog box, we're going to go and check request code and check that it's equal to request date. And if it is, well, we know we're working with, or this has been called from the date dialog. So we're going to create a date object, call it birth date, equal to cast the data that was passed in here. And then I'm going to go get serializable extra to get that extra data that was passed inside of it. And what we specifically want is date dialog fragment dot contact birthday, because that is what was passed. Now that we have the information, we can update contact by calling set date of birth and pass in the birth date. Make sure that's capitalized. And then what else do we have to update? We have to update our contact birthday edit text box. And we do that by calling set text. And then we're going to have to call the contact to get the string version of this, which is going to be get date string. And there it is. And that is all we need to do. So let's execute it. And here are all of our little items. Let's click on Sally Smith. And you're going to see that she opens up here. And if we double click in the little area here for the birth date, you're going to see that our birth date picker shows up. And let's just move this to a little bit later date. Hit OK. And you're going to see that that changed. And if we bounce out, of course, and then bounce back in again, you're going to see that all that information was stored. So that is how to create dialog boxes and how to communicate between fragments. In the next part of the tutorial, I am going to be doing a big giveaway. So anybody out there that stuck around long enough to hear this, you are in luck. Please leave any questions or comments below. Otherwise, till next time.